Okay, now the second function of a constitution is to specify which institution has the decision-making authority in a country or a society. So we agreed on some basic rules to run a society and to cooperate among a society. Now second function says that who will make these basic rules, okay? So let's suppose if it is a country like Soviet Union, remember USSR and US. So if it is Soviet Union, it was run by one party. So their one party system, that was basically the Communist Party, it decided everything, who will run the country and what will be the rules and who will regulate the whole country, who will take the taxes, what will citizens produce, everything. If we take example of country like ours, which is democratic, so in India, since India follows parliamentary form of government and federal form of government, so parliament gets to decide about the authority of the country in India. That is, parliament decide what kind of laws should be. But where will it be written that how will parliament constitute itself? So constitution has to give answer to this question as well, that how will parliament form itself. Okay, so second function should be clear. Second function of the constitution is to specify which institution has the decision making authority in a country or a society. So in a country like ours, the institution of parliament decides the rules and basic laws, and also how will a parliament form should be mentioned in the constitution itself. Okay, so now let us proceed towards the third function of a constitution, is to lay some limits on what a government can impose on its citizens. Okay, now understand in this manner. Let's suppose today government has in India only, the government has announced that black color, okay, you cannot wear black color, or the scheduled caste cannot go to school. So obviously the people of schedule or anything like scheduled caste has to serve the upper caste or the Brahmins. Okay, now why will people of scheduled caste follow the rules or binding from the constitution? Because this is a very unfair thing. Okay, you cannot wear black, this is your personal choice, whatever clothes you want to wear. How can a government ask you to wear this or not to wear this? So that is one thing which will sound unfair, and you will generally say, or you will, you know, show your anger towards the government, and you will say, how can you make such laws? So the third function is to limit on what a government can impose. That means constitution government ko kuch bhi karne ka right nahi deta. Government has to make sure that it is coming in a country like India through the wishes of people, so wo logo ke liye hi kaam kare. So within this, another important thing which you need to understand is about fundamental rights. Okay, so government kabhi bhi koi bhi aisi policy nahi introduce kar sakta jo logo ki fundamental rights ko harm kare ya breach kare. So let's suppose we have right to profess our own religion. Okay, if let's suppose I am Hindu, I am free to choose and do my rituals according to my religion. If I am a Muslim, I am free to wear a skull cap, I am free to do my all the prayers and all my meetings related to my religion. So government cannot pass any rule which will, you know, harm fundamental rights. So fundamental rights, that means are those rights which will be with citizens no matter what. Also, it basically means that the government can never trespass the fundamental rights of citizens. Iska matlab fundamental rights to citizens ke paas hamesha rahegi. Now, constitution has a lots of ifs and buts, okay? Constitution will never give any institution unlimited power so that body of constitution makes misuse of that power. Now, we as citizens have 6 fundamental rights, but in a case of emergency, these fundamental rights do get harmed, or you can say violated. Like for example, let us relate to the situation of COVID-19. I have my fundamental right to live the way I want, but मैं कुछ भी अपने लिविंग में ऐसा नहीं कर सकती जो दूसरे को हार्म करेगा. नाउ दिस इज़ वन सिचुएशन, द COVID-19 सिचुएशन विच इज़ रिलेटेड टू हेल्थ एंड विच इज़ एक्चुअली अफेक्टिंग द होल वर्ल्ड ग्लोबली. सो देयर इज़ द सिचुएशन ऑफ लॉकडाउन, राइट? सो माई फंडामेंटल राइट इज आई कैन मूव ऑन द रोड, आई कैन वॉक ऑन द रोड, बट इफ़ माई लोकेलिटी इज सील्ड. सो माई यू विल से मैम माई फंडामेंटल राइट्स आर ब्रीच्ड. But fundamental rights are not breached here because we are looking the concern of whole society. You might be aware of that within the whole 60-70 years, it is just once that Indira Gandhi imposed emergency in the country, okay? So emergency is one situation where your fundamental rights can be harmed, right? Otherwise, fundamental rights can never be harmed. Also, government can never impose a law or make a rule which will harm the fundamental rights of people. So this fundamental rights in a country like India or in a country which practice democracy gives immense power to citizens, okay?